Let's talk.
Nerd!
Warning, this show contains spoilers.
Spoilers on top of spoilers.
All right. Welcome back, guys, to our weekly, not so weekly podcast. We are finally joined back with Reno after his long vacation of being sick.
Yay.
And once again, this guy, emo looking guy over here.
Emo?
Well, probably not emo, I guess, wouldn't really, but just...
I would say Mexican hombre.
I don't know what that means, but... And then, of course, me and myself, your host, Spatial Warning. So I guess we'll just jump right into it. Before we jump into things, what I'll say is a little Let's Talk Nerds announcement stuff. On our YouTube... I'm going to be starting a playthrough of Elden Ring. Reno here, and maybe we'll see, but definitely Reno will be jumping in and joining me on that adventure from time to time. But I'm planning on trying to do a full playthrough until I get so mad at the game that I break my computer. We'll see what happens. And then Wolf Striker here is going to be starting a little mini... I don't know if you'd call it a mini-series, but just say he's going to be trying to do a daily upload of Halo gameplay. Till it gets better, I guess, to see the progression. And so that'll be up on the YouTube. We'll see what other games... We have Gotham Knights coming out this summer. We'll probably all three play that together.
Be better.
Yeah. And then I think there's going to be a Warhammer game hopefully coming out this year as well. We'll probably play that, but we'll see what else comes out. We'll find stuff to play. So we'll jump right into it, as I said, with Disney Plus's newest rebooted show, Louder and Prouder? Is that what it's called?
Yeah, Louder and Prouder.
Yeah, the Proud Family, Louder and Prouder. Reboot, obviously, of the Proud Family. When did it come out, Peng? Or Reno, do you have it written down there?
Yeah, I have it written down. It came out in 2001, and it was canceled in 2005 of August. So September 15th, 2001, it came out, and August 19th, 2005 is when it was canceled, I guess. They had two seasons of it with 52 episodes and a movie.
Ooh.
Their seasons were a lot bigger. I don't know how many episodes seasons are now with this one. So.
Nowadays, it seems like seasons. Yeah, seasons. Yeah, it's like 12 episodes a season usually, right?
Yeah, they're taking the anime trend where, 12 episodes.
Yeah.
Just to see, the pilot season.
Mm-hmm. I think sometimes you go up about... I think the max you see nowadays is usually, 24, I think.
Yeah.
On average. I mean, sometimes you have longer seasons, but yeah, that's crazy to have so many episodes. I guess with that, though, it doesn't really matter because they don't really usually, those cartoons, they only follow a consecutive story.
Yeah, you could go jump in at any spot and not really miss anything, I think.
Yeah.
But I didn't really watch The Proud Family all that much to know about it, so.
Yeah, I watched it a little bit when I was younger. It wasn't my favorite show, but it was. I remember enjoying it a little bit, and I tried rewatching it now. But you can tell it's definitely one of those cartoons that's aged not the best.
But how could you say that?
I don't know. The animation's a lot better and crisper because I watched both the episodes. I liked it. It came out where you could tell that she aged and everything like that. Where she's in. Is she starting high school or is she in the middle of high school?
I believe she's a freshman. I think she's supposed to be 14 or something.
Okay, because in the other ones you could tell that she was a lot younger, probably in middle school or just starting middle school and coming into her character and stuff like that. So I enjoyed it. It was okay. It hit a lot of the what's going on now and the technology and all that stuff where, back in 2001 we had cell phones, but they weren't like cell phones now. Internet wasn't as good as now. And, they didn't have so many, the second episode's influencers like they do now. I mean, there was a couple people who maybe watched YouTube and this and that, but you weren't making big money being on YouTube, I don't think, back then in 2001.
Well, I don't even think YouTube was a thing in 2001.
YouTube wasn't even a thing yet?
No, I don't think.
2010, I think, is when they were made.
Yeah.
Or 2009.
Yeah.
2009 or 10.
Okay. Yeah, because I don't really know. I wasn't really. I wasn't to computers and stuff back then, but I didn't really browse the web all that much. And
cable TV.
Yeah. And stuff. I played a lot of video games back then.
Was MySpace barely starting up?
Was it MySpace?
In 2001? I don't know. I've never been on social media. I thought you would have had a MySpace.
No, I never had a MySpace. I didn't start being on social media until there's Facebook. I think Jody had a MySpace. But that only lasted maybe 3 years before Facebook came out and just totally took over everything. I think Napster was the big thing back then, because Napster first started coming out, I think, in 2000, but I'm not sure where it was. Mm-hmm. There was a lot of sharing and stuff like that, and then they got in trouble. But it was still, the wireless wasn't as good as it is now. I mean, we didn't have high-speed internet. We had still, you know, phone internet and DSL. So it wasn't as quick. If you're going to download something, it took at least a week or two or a couple days to get it finished, especially if it was a video. If it was music, probably pretty quick. But if it was a video, it would be a while for it to download.
Yeah. And only, well, not 20 years, I'd say 10 years. And look at where we're at now.
But I could tell the difference because I watched the first episode of The Proud Family that came out in 2001, and you could tell the animation difference of that one and this one, where this is old digital. I'm not sure if they animated it how the old days, where they're just sketching it out, but you could tell how much digital art has came up from then. Mm-hmm.
What did you think of the first two episodes, Wolf?
I enjoyed the first episode a lot more than the second.
Mm-hmm.
But it has its charms. It definitely aged a lot better with the times.
So what did you like about the first episode more than the second?
I'd say it did the humor a lot better. And the second one, the second episode, they kind of held back a little.
Mm-hmm.
They're holding back their hand. But I'd say, this is a show that I can see promise and a future for Disney. It's going to get a lot of people jumping on it since, black lead.
Yeah. Well, black and Mexican.
Yeah. It's the Mexican. Yeah. The best.
I don't know. The second episode to me, I do really like the first episode. It was really a good starter. But the second one to me, I really liked because it just, all the humor was so apparent with, like, modern just problems with kids and, like, the whole, like, the way they joked around about being canceled. I know they're joking about it, but, like, and it's dramatized to an extent, but, like, it's almost like that where, like, people will just cancel each other.
Yeah.
Just on a whim like that. And it's really funny to be seen like that. Yeah. And how people will just buy into influencers like nothing.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I love to see. I really do hope that Disney Plus kind of goes down this like road of like rebooting some of their older shows. I would love to see like a reboot, maybe like Kim Possible or some of those older like mid-2000 shows. What was that? Jake Long, American Dragon, American Chinese Dragon. That would be a good reboot.
That'd be a nice one. Not sure if I'll watch it. Didn't really enjoy it when it was out, but it'd be an interesting one.
What was the Disney Channel cartoon in that time that you watched? I mean, I guess you were pretty young, but...
Well, yeah, but just because it showed before I was even, even acknowledged my consciousness, doesn't mean they reruns.
True, I guess, but doesn't mean you pay attention to them.
Yeah.
It's like, because like when they're rerunning, there's other options to watch, where like when they are being aired for the first time, there's not usually as many other options, especially in that time period.
Yeah, but reruns are there for a reason.
So, what was the What's a Disney cartoon you want to see rebooted then?
Disney?
Yeah.
Gravity Falls.
Didn't that just come out?
Well, the series technically ended. Technically, I think.
Oh, it's done? I thought they were going to have more because my son was just watching that and it's
they're still doing reruns of it.
Oh, because it's a good...
I think that came out in 2008, sometime around there.
Okay. No. I came out way after 2008.
Somewhere. Yeah.
But no, it's been out for a decent amount of time, but it definitely was a very short-lived series.
Oh, I didn't know they canceled it.
Well, I think...
That's when it came out.
Well, the creators pretty much told the story they wanted to tell, and then they finished it, and they just didn't go on from there. Like Phineas and Ferb.
Yeah, why continue a story which is already done?
Yeah.
Looking at Star Wars right now.
Damn. You could have like Maple and Dipper being older, like being teenagers or something.
Well, they could make a movie. There's a lot of story that could be done with that.
Yeah. But don't force somebody that already finished their passion to continue them.
Yeah, it would have to be, somebody would have to pick it up and rewrite it. So it might not be as good if it was a new writer. So.
Yeah, that's never good because with the original vision, it's gone because it's, you know, it's not you who sees it. It was them.
Yeah.
But, I say Star Wars, like, even though I would love to see new content from Star Wars that isn't from the past, I guess continue not risking, you know, a failure of what the prequels, the sequels are, I guess. Not the newer ones.
Yeah, that was weird. Because even the Book of Boba didn't do that well. Or not well, but like we had very mixed feelings.
Yeah. But I guess this is mainly a problem with Hollywood and just anything. They don't want to take a risk on making new stories. They want to reuse established stories so they don't get shit on by reviews and lose money.
Mm-hmm. What do you think, Pang? Reno?
A new series?
Yeah, well, like new series, Hollywood not wanting to take new steps and stuff.
I don't know. I think a lot of stuff has already been done that it's hard to think of something new. I mean, Lord of the Rings has, you know, it's been done. The Matrix, they just redid that, which was okay, but, you know. It's the Matrix. I mean, they just redid Ghostbusters again, which I liked. I liked the remake, but it brings you back to when you're watching it. It's all, well, I want to watch the first three now. So, I mean, I think that's what a lot of they're hitting on now is let's make a movie to make people watch these older movies. Because if the younger kids watch these newer movies, then they're going to watch these older movies, even though they probably watch these older movies because if their parents are all, oh, a new Ghostbusters is coming out, usually they'll be like, oh, let's watch the old Ghostbusters because you could find those easily. So I think that's what they're mostly focusing on now is, okay, well, let's reboot this so they'll watch the old ones again.
Yeah.
Well, I guess it's just that... The thing about looking for new stories is that you gotta imagine them, but you gotta also look for inspiration, and not use that inspiration as your whole thing, which, as you see in some movies, where they're just they're just copies of others, pretty much.
Well, I mean, because look at inspiration, but a lot of it's been done. I mean, a black family. That's been done a lot through, you know, since the 90s. I mean, Martin, Moesha, you know, the Proud Family. They've had a lot of those influences. The Fresh Prince, which they made a new one of that too. So they've made a lot of that, you know, kind of stuff, shows, and which, you know, a lot of them did really good. I mean, even with the white, you know, white basic suburban family, they have a lot of shows like that. They've had, you know, the Asian, you know, typical show too, Fresh Off the Boat. I can't really think of any other ones, but, you know, and now they have that other show, that other sitcom where they have a mixture, you know, a mixed family, I think. I forgot what it's called, though. Can't think of it in the top of my head. But, I mean, it's all been done. So, I mean, the only thing I could think of that somebody could write that really hasn't been done is... I don't know. Like I said, it's all been done. I mean, they have villains being good guys. They have good guys becoming villains. I mean, a lot of the comic book stuff that I wished for when I was a kid is out now. I mean, there's really not that much more to do. Since I watched The Proud Family, it brought me back to that one cartoon called Recess. Do you guys remember that cartoon? You know, that's a good one to redo because there's really not that much about, you know, those, because they had a different variety of kids in that one. You know, they had the big white kid. They had the black girl. I think they had the black kid who played basketball. They had the white kid, the nerdy kid. I think one of the girls were Mexican, and they had the nerdy girl. I mean, you could do a lot with that kind of characters. And that's, I think, what the creator of The Proud Family wanted to do, too, is he wants to introduce a lot of new characters. I mean, that's why it's Michael? Is he he's the flamboyant one?
He isn't a new character. He's from the...
Yeah, he's from the old one, but they made him more flamboyant and proud and, you know, out there. So, you know, I mean, and I think that's a good concept to have. I mean, because in the other one, they were kind of hinting that he was gay, but it wasn't real. They didn't really put it out there all that much. Even though, like, the first episode, they showed him trying out for cheerleading, but... his character didn't have pink hair and stuff. He just wore that sweatshirt that was not over his shoulder. So, I mean, it's good to see that kind of stuff, even though some shows really throw it out there where this show didn't really throw it out there all that much. I think they just showed him and then he was just helping them out to be their best selves, which was nice.
Okay. I see. But I gotta give minus points to the character because of his parents. Like, you gotta want something more interesting than just a stereotypical gay parent raising gay son or gay daughter. it's not great looking. Like, it's cool. The representation isn't bad. It's actually pretty good. But I prefer not to see some stereotypes being thrown like that. As you see, as my type, you know, my people get drawn as typical Hispanic.
What are you trying to say, Wolf?
Cultural appropriation for Hispanic women in shows. That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
Unless they're hot.
Okay.
This is the. I don't like when they strike at stereotypes a lot harder. Well, not harder, but just. Certain stereotypes when I'm writing a character, like, even if it's true, doesn't mean you have to.
Yeah, but I think most shows do that just to throw it out there to be all like, well, this is the stereotype of that. And a lot of people think that that's a stereotype. I mean, and a lot of people joke about that kind of stereotype and you know, like, Asians are bad drivers. You see that everywhere. Or people making fun of Asians being bad drivers. I mean, some Asians are good drivers, I assume.
Well, judging from, like, you know, Asian countries, I don't think they're Their car accidents over there is much bigger than ours.
Well, maybe they're scooter accidents.
You know what they say, the more they smile, the less they see.
Damn. Well, we're canceled now.
Yeah, so nice run, guys.
Yeah, it's been a good run.
Time to change the name. Whoa. But anything else?
Anything else? Pete, well, I guess we can transition on to Peacemaker? Yeah, nice Peacemaker. Finale. Yeah, the grand finale.
Barry Allen, I forget his actor, but I know the other guy, Jason Momoa. Aquaman, I like how they could get those two in.
Oh, yeah, that was funny. You guys are late again, as usual.
Have fun fucking fish.
Yeah.
Jesus. I hate these rumors. But it's true, isn't it?
See, and that's a stereotype. Do all fish guys fuck fish?
Probably.
It's the only thing they say.
Yeah. Yeah, that was a good way for them to end it. That was awesome. Poor cow.
All they had to do is just wait.
It was interesting. I mean, it's a good show. It hits on all the things that I like about an anti superhero, I guess, because he's a superhero, but not really a superhero. Where people don't even know him. Where people don't even know who he is in the beginning of the episodes. And when
he stopped the most dangerous villain ever. Kite Man. No, I was going to say Kite Man. Remember? There was like, I guess he went and talked to like that janitor's like niece's class or whatever. He's like, yes, I stopped Kite Man once.
Can't wait to see him up here. But I enjoyed it. The whole show was fun to see. Had some laughs. Unforeseen nudity.
Yes. Dude, the first two episodes really were like just a slap in the face because I really did not expect any of that. Like from the nudity, the humor, the death, the racism. Like literally like the part where I remember when Wolf and I were watching it together and that his dad like sat down and when he first got to jail and all the guys surrounded him. We were like, oh, he's going to get beat up. No.
They started being racist.
Yeah. Well, some Hitler shit.
I looked up some stuff about Peacemaker. I was just wondering about his character and stuff like that in the comic books. So Peacemaker's first appearance was in Fighting number 5. And it was the number 40th comic in that in 1966. Peacemaker's comic was a 5-issue. He had a 5-issue comic from March to November 1967. And in the mid-1980s, DC Comics acquired the Peacemaker and released a 4-issue miniseries in January to April in 1988. So he did have a Nazi dad that made him become Peacemaker, but he was kind of went crazy because everybody he killed for peace kind of like he thought that they were absorbing in his helmet and talking to him. Pretty interesting character. And then I was wondering too about Vigilante because I've never really heard anything about that character, so I wondered if they were partners or teammates or anything. But Vigilante first was in the new Teen Titans number 23 in 1982, and he was a district attorney where his wife and child got killed by mobsters, so he became the Vigilante. And then he demasked a Peacemaker on live TV and then committed suicide.
That's what the fucking Scarecrow could have done in the Arkham games. Big ass Batman and just killed himself. That's how you send a message.
But yeah, so there are two other people picked up the vigilante mask, I guess, in the series. And it was Judge Allen and Bailiff Dave Winston who took the vigilante role. And Peacemaker killed them, and that made the old Peacemaker come back and then de-mask him, I guess, the district attorney one. So now in the comic, the last time you see Vigilante is he's in purgatory, and he helps heroes who get into purgatory fight off those gods so they could escape.
Interesting.
Yes. God.
Now that's a story I need to see animated.
If we're going to hell.
Yeah, right. No, hell no, yeah. No.
He's going to be a jackass in there.
But, yeah. I mean, I liked how they made Peacemaker their own. It was nice when he was jumping off the buildings and crashing down where you could see him, like, that kind of hurt me sometimes when he was just falling from building to building trying to escape from the cops, and how he's just trying not to kill people and trying not to kill cops and trying to be good, but it just always happens where it just gets messed up. It's kind of like if Deadpool had a TV series, I think it would be like this. And I wouldn't mind seeing Deadpool in his show.
Yeah.
I think that's kind of what Vigilante is supposed to be, but...
Yeah, Deadpool.
You know, he has a little bit of brains. Vigilante is supposed to be an uneducated person.
Yeah. To put it nicely.
I like his character. He has a certain... He has certain times where he shines.
When he took over as sniper for Peacemaker.
Yeah, but most of the time he's kind of uncomfortable to fucking hear.
Yeah, he's cringy.
Yeah, cringy. It kind of just like some of the jokes he makes are just like, okay, who gave him the mic? He wasn't supposed to show up to the studio today.
Yeah, well, I think they wrote this series really good. I think even coming in with right after it was like a couple months after the movie came out, the Suicide Squad movie. So he was. How they were talking about that and how he had to fight the starfish when they said that he has to fight these butterflies. He was all, well, the starfish was a big-ass starfish. So are the butterflies butterflies? And then, of course, they were butterflies. So it was just interesting, and I liked how they, okay, from the movie to this, it's still the same character as in the movie. So it was nice to see that, too, where they just didn't start it like, okay, well, this is a whole different thing than the movie was.
Or this was before the movie.
Yeah, or
this was my concern. Is like I thought but before the show started, a lot of people were pretty sure he died.
Yeah, but that whole building fell on him, and they said that the whole building, anyone else would have died because that whole building fell on him.
Yeah,
but he's a main character.
Yep, he had plot armor.
And then they showed not a building, but they showed that whole thing collapse on him in the show too when he was trying to get to the cow.
Yep.
Which I loved how they killed the cow. It was so fun. What was that? So torpedo human, helmet?
Human torpedo.
Yeah, human. Oh, that was hilarious.
Poor cow.
Poor butterfly. Well,
yeah.
He's a caterpillar more than anything.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah,
caterpillar reminds me of Monsters versus Aliens.
You know,
the big caterpillar.
And yeah.
What was it? Did they have two movies, or was it towards the end where he turns into a butterfly?
Of Monsters or
yeah, Monsters versus Aliens.
Yeah, it's more towards the end. When he turned into the giant butterfly.
But yeah, that's what it reminds me of. Like, is that seeing a big butterfly or not, but if a caterpillar like that.
Hmm.
It's just alien versus monsters.
But I mean, I liked all the characters in it and stuff. The big white guy, dye beard.
poor Cobra Kai.
I want to see more of the leprechaun.
Yeah, I want to see him. I want to see him eat more Cheetos. Have some more of that product placement.
Hell yeah!
And that was one thing that Wolf called out a lot, was their nonchalant product placement.
Yeah, well, the one that mainly talked about it was the car.
Yeah,
they had product placement for that car. They've been showing it like from the front and back.
Mm-hmm.
I'm guessing the only thing they didn't really show well was that the wheels and windows can be destroyed easily.
Well, I'm just wondering what's gonna happen in season two, what they're gonna fight and stuff like that,
because
I think that this season did really good. I would expect them to do a season two. You know, all the cops are gone though.
Yeah, they're gone.
So it's gonna be the main black ops, but all the other like side characters are,
you go to Gotham City.
Yeah, basically gone.
Actually, no. I don't think they're gonna be black ops, since they probably will still be working under Amanda Waller, but her daughter will probably not.
Do you think that she's gonna not be in the show? Because she was a good character too.
No, she'll probably be there, but more as a supporting character.
Okay. Oh yeah, because she outed everything.
Yeah, she outed that. Like she spoke out about the secret mission and all that.
Yeah.
Well, she's dead now.
Yeah, gets her kid. Okay, I'm coming with. Well, yep.
Yep. Later, guys.
Gotta go outside. Wonder what's gonna be the new threat. I'm putting money down on your mom. You know, like.
His mom.
Ooh. Oh. Jerry. He's even worse than the dad.
Even worse than the dad.
Mama fucking
Bear angers at not to be trafficked with.
She's like a Russian communist.
A Russian mother.
It makes sense without Biggie fucking.
Do you think they would let him have his own movie?
Peacekeeper?
Yeah.
Probably if it goes well.
If it keeps going. If they can, maybe he'll make cameos in the next Justice League movie.
Calling them out like being late.
Why the hell are you guys just now showing up? And also, Aquaman fucks fish.
I like how he always made fun of every single superhero whenever they bring him up.
Right? It'd be funny if they brought Wonder Woman. I'd be like, yeah, I fucked her.
They both had a thing.
Well, didn't he say something about her when he was in the kids? Because the kids were asking about Wonder Woman.
So he said he had a fling with her?
Yeah, something like that. That's great. Reno, you got anything else you want to talk about this week? It's been pretty dry last month or so, but
I've been playing Dying Light, the first one, because I wanted Dying Light 2, but
talk about something new.
Oh, Dying Light, yeah. the first Dying Light is still it's a pretty good game. I mean, to play through and every, a lot of people still. Yeah, a lot of people still play it. Yeah, so I was surprised.
A lot of people are still, like, even now, a lot of people are saying the first one's still better than the new one that just came out.
Yeah.
The first one has, like, years upon updates, even till now. So, I better hope it's better than something that new that released, like, recently.
But I think, like, people are saying, like, even compared to release Dying Light, it's still, release Dying Light is still better than the new one.
I guess.
I don't know. I guess people are saying, like, side quests were super tedious in the new one. Like, there's literally a quest where you have to go find a girl a new pair of shoes.
Hell yeah! What I always wanted to be. A messenger boy. Well, not a messenger boy, but what were you calling? A delivery boy?
Yeah. Well, she's literally, I remember watching the cutscenes, like, and now my new pair of sneakers are ruined. So go get me a new pair of sneakers. And your character literally says, wait, what? And no, your character literally says, like, are you serious? And then she's like, yeah, I'm serious, and blah, blah, blah. And so,
I'm the best of you.
So do you know, are you still playing the same character that you played in the first one?
No, or he died. He died. He died from the zombie infection. There's no way he would have lived.
Oh, okay. Because I've been playing the first one, and, you know, they just show him beat the big bad guy. I mean, he has the infection, but it doesn't say that he died or anything. And then I've been playing the following, the DLCs. Him.
Okay. Yeah, finish him. He does die. He does. He's not the second one. It'll be amazing.
Okay.
But, sadly.
Well, because I'm playing the DLC, the following, right now, and he's just found, like, some kind of other cure that will help him live longer. So.
Yeah. What jokes on you?
Yeah, thanks for ruining it for me, Wolf. Thanks.
Oh, well, so I ruined the 5-6-year-old game that you just never bothered to finish.
I have too many games.
Yeah, okay.
Too many, but yet too little.
Yeah, I have too many games and not enough time to play, so.
What do you do? Just bring your whole setup to your workplace.
That's the plan.
He is working on
that. You get more time if you do that. So.
All right, how about you, Wolf? You got anything you want to talk about this week?
Cuphead.
Oh, okay.
I'm not watching season 2. It's like, if I had a kid about ye big, he can watch it.
Mm-hmm.
But too bad I won't have a kid, ye big. Because fuck paying child support, you know? But, yeah, it's alright. Like, I can't...
So, you're already planning to leave your family.
Yeah. Hey, at least he's planning. See? Okay.
Hear that, girls? You have a real catch right there.
10 out of 10.
You're gonna get that nets and just trying to keep me.
Well, my son, he wants to watch the Cuphead, so
yeah, he can watch. Well, it's nothing. It's nothing too bad.
Yeah, I mean, I've played
religion. They has a literal devil, but he doesn't do much of devilish shit other than, you know, take people's soul in a cartoonish way.
And I've played the game with him. That game, the Cuphead game, is really hard.
Yeah, it's meant to be.
Yeah,
I can't. Really meant to be. Yeah, there's, I don't think I can't even pass the second boss or something like that. I like gave up on that game.
Let your child try and go at it. He'll beat it in like at least a week.
Wait, you couldn't even beat the second boss of Cuphead, but yet you want to play Elden Ring?
Yes, I want to try Elden Ring out. But
I want to be a platformer, but I want to move to a harder game that isn't a platformer, that's 3D.
But that will be more of, we'll have a team to fight.
So you're expecting me to carry you?
Yes. Well, other people on our team.
Well, there won't be any. You realize that the only way, it's not like a giant open world online game. Well, I guess it is kind of, but like, it's not like anyone and everyone can just join. There's not going to be like 50 players running around.
Can't you have 4 players on your co-op though?
I believe so, yeah. But you have to invite them and everything.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And their story doesn't really progress. It's just that world story that you guys load into. Loading, like, the Dark Souls games, and, like, obviously with Elden Ring now, and, like, all those games, when it came to playing multiplayer, is really weird how it works. It's kind of complicated. So I'm not looking forward to, like, trying to do that, but... I played, so when it came to Elden Ring, I played, or like the makers of Elden Ring and like those types of games. I've only ever played Dark Souls 3 very briefly with a friend. Wolf remembers them as felines.
yes. Yeah.
So, and the thing is when I played it, all I did was they joined my world, gave me like all in-game loot, and then we just like, they just, them and one of his friends joined, and they kind of just carried me through most of the game, because the whole goal was to get me to a point, I guess in Dark Souls 3, there's like this one area of the world where everyone does PvP.
Oh, okay. So they wanted you to just be, to play PvP with them.
Yeah, so they wanted, they got me all the way to there, and then I stopped playing. Logged out that. PvP in Dark Souls is stupid.
I played the first. I played the first Dark Souls. It was fun. I think I got pretty far in it, but I don't remember passing the game.
I commend you, good sir.
But yeah. But yeah, I think it was the first Dark Souls that I was playing. And then I think I tried to play it again, and I was just still like, I remember playing certain parts, and I was like, yeah, I'm not going to do this again.
How about you, Wolf? Did you ever play any Dark Souls games? Or
no.
Ghost of Tsushima? Whatever that was?
I haven't played any.
Or Bloodborne, I think, another one. Either you played Bloodborne?
No. I think two of those are on PlayStation.
Oh, yeah. Damn, no. PlayStation. No. Yeah. So, I mean, this will be kind of my first actual introduction to the franchise.
Well, that's good. So, I mean, sometimes it's better to play the game all yourself or with somebody else who's on the same level from start to finish, because
mm-hmm.
you don't get carried. You get to fight, and you get to learn how to play the game, than somebody just giving you this weapon and be like, okay, now you could slaughter everybody in, you know, one hit.
I don't know. It was pretty fun running around Dark Souls with OP weapons.
Yeah.
But I'm pretty sure that what's it called? At least the good thing about Elden Ring is that, as far as I know, I don't believe there's story. They're completely different stories from Dark Souls. It's just the same mechanics or very similar mechanics. So,
yeah.
We'll see. That'll be a fun playthrough. Between that and Wolf's daily uploads, people should be entertained. Yeah, and once Reno gets his stuff put together, he can do stuff.
Well, yeah, that's to do with more of computer components than anything else.
Why are you shaking your head, Wolf?
who's shaking your head?
Yeah, I wonder.
Who did that? Some guy outside? No.
Imagine there was a guy out your window.
Holy shit. He's offering milkshakes if I slap his ass. That's not a right take.
That reminds me of the meme where like the guy's like, this guy offered me hot Cheetos if I sucked his dick. I told him that's fucking gay. And you know, he just like shows up in the camera view with the bag of hot Cheetos. Like, yeah. Well, anyway, that happened over there.
Unexpected comedies.
All right. Well, I think that's everything we got for this week, right?
No.
Well, you got something else you want to talk about?
My feelings.
Go on.
I need support, you know.
That's gonna take more than one podcast.
Yeah, we gotta take another. Well, I guess next podcast we can talk about it.
All right, we'll talk about your feelings all next podcast. We'll put a whole segment just for you.
Thank you.
The Wolf Striker show.
The Wolf Striker. I think it'll be the Wolf Striker segment.
Weekly. Feelings with Wolf Striker. Everything is pain.
And a lie. Technical difficulties.
How can I feel it? Nothing but everything.
Yes. Well, how did you reply? You said,
by being enlightened, I think.
Yeah, I was being enlightened, and I said, I'd rather die. You see? It's a good back and forth.
Yeah. This is how we text.
Very text. Depressing.
And then I said, good for you, man. Halo?
Halo? Yes. A fun game. Had a fun time.
Guys.
Can't wait to be doing daily uploads of Halo and realizing how much time I wasted.
You know, it'll be okay in 6 months.
In 6 months. Yeah.
Real way, I mean, hey, or in hopefully in like 3 more months, we can just do daily uploads of us doing co-op campaign together.
Fuck yeah. Well, I think the playthrough I'm going to do with, Nova and others is going to be way more fun. Like, we could do a legit one. But the one that me and Nova are playing is just getting the tank heads, which you can get at the start of the game, and just beating the game as fast as you can.
Okay. I mean, the thing is, I don't think that'd be like, obviously, if you're going to record that and play through it, it'd be, I just don't think it'd be a very, obviously, like, you can do that really fast, so it just wouldn't be a super long series.
Yeah. But it'd be a fun one.
But I think what would be fun is doing, like, a co-op, like, sweep of everything. I can just do everything, kill everything, co-op.
Legendary, with skulls on. And you just know, that's the title. Co-op with friends, legendary, skulls on.
We can do it.
Yeah, we definitely
can. We're going to cry a lot, but we can do it.
Yeah. It's going to be a pain, but it's going to be fun.
Yeah. Looks like shoot, even Reno could join us.
Yeah.
Oh. On PvP?
No. Campaign.
Okay. Yeah, campaign call. If we were going to invite you to PvP, why should we? We have my dogs.
Yeah, they'd probably be better at it.
They're just as good.
That's not nice.
It's true, though.
Don't worry. We can teach you the ropes of the multiplayer.
At least if they do... If they do what they're saying they might do, what's it called? They'll probably hopefully release the PvE mode, and then you can play that with us.
Okay.
Yeah, PvE.
Yeah, so you can... Yeah.
I played some of the campaign for Halo, but my computer is, when I tried to record it, it still wasn't playing, yeah. So, but I could play it, and it was fine. I had fun with it. It was fun.
Good. You'll be, hopefully whenever they have co-op, as long as they release 3-player co-op and not just 2-player co-op, the three of us can run through it with, like, full legendary, like, goals and everything. It'll be fun.
Are they going to do 3-player co-op? Did they say they were going to do 3-player?
Every Halo games, well, besides like the first two, has been 4-player co-op.
Oh, okay. I thought it was I thought they've always only had 2-player.
No, Halo 1 and 2 were 2-player co-op for the campaign. And then Halo 3 and up were all 4-player.
Oh, okay.
So, we'll just have to see if they're dumb or not.
Well, I'll look forward to that since...
If it isn't 4 players, I may lose a lot more faith than I should.
And that's not much faith to begin with. But like, we're not given them high expectations. We're just asking for normal co-op here.
I'm just asking to have fun.
Okay. Well.
Well.
Well, with that, I think that's all, right?
Yeah, that's it. That's all.
All right. We'll see if Wolf makes it another week to join us next week, but...
Yeah. I'll try?
Yeah! He said he'll try. But, all right, well, as usual, this is Let's Talk Nerds. I'm Special Horny.
I'm Reno.
And I'm Wolf Striker. Yeah.
All right. Bye-bye.
See ya.